confused. So I was like, you know what? I'll just play it in my spare time. So no idea what the hell we're going to play next. For stream.
Car.
Anywho, there's an ad. But wow, that's taking 1 second.
Four wheels.
Before I can... Skip.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's people talking right now on the stream. But anywho, it's time. It's time. I'm trying to remember that if I clap, it peaks my microphone, so I have to just I have to do one of these and just kind of like stop at the last second. It's a pain in the ass. But how the frick is it going? How the frick are you today? I hope you have a wonderful freaking Thursday. Hell yeah. It's time. It's time, everyone. We're finally getting Summer Game Fest. How the frick is it going, Artsling? Hell yeah. I don't know why I saluted. That's my new thing. I salute people. I'm now John Cena or something. Hell yeah, that's a cute, cozy emote. Oh my god, it's got kittens! That I've just yelled into my microphone. My bad. Feel free to let me know how the audio sounds, because I'm never really sure. I want to make sure that I'm not being drowned out by the stuff going on with these three individuals, whoever they are. I like the middle dude. He has a great style. Loving the headband and the hair going to the side. The guy on the right, he looks clean. He looks fresh. Hell yeah. Lady on the left, he looks fantastic. Hell yeah. Don't know what this is. I don't know what P4A is, but when I saw that, I thought it was like Persona 4 Anniversary. I was really confused. If you haven't been able to tell by the music, I've been kind of obsessed with Persona lately. So yeah, that's been wild. It's been really fun though, like really, really fun. But yeah, so this is Summer Game Fest, specifically the kickoff show, which Jeff Keighley did say that it was going to be almost like an E3 conference in a sense, where they were going to show a bunch of stuff. And like have like an all-out blast of news with like some smaller, maybe some smaller or some extra bits of news to come later on, like down the line or something like that, which is pretty cool. So we've got this today. I did write a little itinerary that I guess I can really quickly try and pull up if I have the time. I think I should.
Tam.
E3 2021. All right, so today is Summer Game Fest. Next stream will be Saturday. I'm going to be checking out the Wholesome Games Showcase, which is something I discovered the other day. It sounds adorable. And that's going to be at 6 p.m. So right now, as of right now, for anyone that may not know time conversions, for me, it is 7 p.m. So my time, 6 p.m, would be an hour back from now. Basically, lurking while playing Warframe. Hell yeah, enjoy your Warframe. Hell yeah. But, so yeah, that'll be at 6 p.m, Wholesome Games. Hopefully that'll be really cute and awesome. And I don't know what to expect from that, but it sounds cool. Then Devolver is doing another thing at 9:30. Oh god. Is doing another thing at 9:30. I'll talk more about this at the end as well. So I'm going to be checking that out. Then we've got Gearbox at 10 p.m, so that's everything for Saturday. And then June 13th, we've got Xbox at 6 p.m, Square Enix at 8:15, and June 14th is Capcom at 10:30 or 10 p.m. Either way.
Welcome to Summer Game Fest Kickoff Live.
Hell yeah. Also, I have my fan on, so apologies if you can hear a little bit of it. But it's way too hot to not have it on today.
Play every day, some surprises, and special guests, including Jeff Goldblum, Giancarlo Esposito,
Jeff Goldblum.
Performances by Weezer, Japanese Breakfast, and the Sonic the Hedgehog Symphony Orchestra. Yes, that's really
okay. Good. That's weird, but okay. I'm going to be muting during Weezer and Japanese Breakfast. Was that? I keep going to say the Japanese House, which is a band I like.
I'm allowed to tell you right now. This is just the start of a.
But yeah, I will be muting during those performances for copyright reasons.
Streamed events from publishers like Xbox and Bethesda, Square Enix, Ubisoft, and more. You can head right now to summergamefest.com to track all the events.
It's E3 season, baby! Hell yeah! I'm excited. I'm hype.
But today,
also, I have rum and coke. So, drinky poos! So, cheers! There you go. Hell yeah.
PC, PlayStation, or Xbox. The biggest games in the world will be here, and some of the smallest ones too. Made by emerging voices and developers from around the
indie
world
games. Woo!
Represent what's next. Thank you so much for tuning in and kicking off video.
Please be good.
Summer.
Please be good.
With a brand new game announcement, you're about to see the world premiere of the next great adventure from Gearbox and 2K.
Yes! Straight away! Come on, Tiny Tina! Let's go! If it is Tiny Tina. It might not be. It could be somewhere else. But I feel like it is. That's what the leaks are saying, anyway. I just hope it's a good game, because I'm not sure how to feel about it.
Fate.
Oh, that looks pretty.
It soars on the wind. It rises from the grave.
Oh, so I hope you're having a good day, Artling. I hope you're having a good freaking Thursday. That's me! They said my name! I'm in the game! Confirmed! I made this! I'm in it!
You cannot hide from fate.
So this is actually going to be a Bunkers and Badasses game from the look of it. Please be a proper Borderlands game. I don't want like a turn-based RPG or something. Andy Samberg? What the fuck? Will Arnett? Hell yeah. Is this Princess Fluffy Butt or whatever she- Oh wait. Butt Stallion. Please, I just want this to be a good game. I'm nervous because it seems like a spin-off, so I'm not sure what to expect. Wonderlands! Wonderlands! Why is she a child again? That's weird. That's very confusing. Why is she a kid again? I thought this was going to be like adult Tiny Tina.
Tiny
Ashley Birch is here.
Now is Tiny Tina herself, Ashley Birch. Hey Ash, how you
What's
doing?
Up, baby? How you doing?
Great to have you here. So I think
Hell
the
yeah.
question everyone's going to have is, what is Wonderlands? What can you tell us about it?
It's a great question. Yeah. It's a high fantasy take on a looter shooter, as you saw. And if you're a fan of Borderlands, you'll probably recognize some fantasy elements.
Hell yeah.
By Assault on Dragon Keep, which was the Borderlands 2 DLC that was beloved by the devs. And so this kind of inspired Wonderlands.
Now, I think the elephant in the room is this a Borderlands game? Is it not? How does it relate?
So it actually isn't. It's its own standalone game.
Okay.
People what? That love Borderlands are going to find lots of elements to love about Wonderlands, but it's its own thing. Tiny Tina's got her own thing going on now. So it's got its own mechanics. There's spell casting. You can customize your character.
All right.
Time, which is super exciting.
All right.
And yeah.
That
so
sounds good.
If you love Borderlands, you're going to find stuff to love in this.
Show more at the Gearbox thing.
This is a great place to start.
Okay, well, Tiny Tina gets her own game, which is fantastic.
Yes.
What is her role? Why does she
I guarantee you don't play as her, though.
She is your bunker master.
Don't fucking knew it.
She's kind of guiding the narrative and changing it on a dime if she wants. And she's just taking your cast of characters, which is an amazing cast, through this wacky world. And she's taking you on an adventure to defeat the Dragon Lord.
And
who is that? I don't know. You'll have to play.
And I wonder who plays the Dragon Lord, because you've got quite the voice cast, including you in this, which is awesome. So feels like such a big experience. So this was a bit of a tease, announcing it's out there. When will we find out more about this game?
Hopefully this summer, and you can find out a lot more at playwonderlands.com if you'd like.
Okay.
But yeah, just...
What about the Gearbox show thing? Why wouldn't they show that at the Gearbox thing in a few days? That's weird.
Alright, well, now it is time for another brand new game
announcement. That's really weird, but okay.
A classic 90s franchise is coming back to life as a grid-based tactical strategy title.
Never mind.
On PC.
Never mind.
Insanely fun trailer.
I was excited for a second when he said 90s franchise, then he said grid tactical based game. I'm like, oh, never mind. I recognize this. I can't remember what it's called, though. Polo! Oh, Metal Slug, right. That's cool, though. This music is bumping. Hell yeah. Why does that look like Futaba? A little bit, from Persona 5, kind of. Like I said, I've been looking at way too much Persona related stuff lately. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. Mmm. I just really hope that this show doesn't have one of those segments where they sit there and talk about one game for like half an hour. Because I don't like those segments, just because there's always going to be a game that I don't care about, I'm not interested in, and they talk about it for like half an hour or something ridiculous, and it ends up being the most boring thing to sit through. Like, what they did with that Borderlands game was like really snappy. It was it got to the point, and then it got on with things. It didn't overstay its welcome. Super Vehicle 001. Okay, don't know what that means, but okay.
Big announcement for you from a surprise guest, but it's well past 3 a.m. their time. So don't worry, we chatted earlier, and I'm very excited to share this with you right now. Hello, mystery guest.
Kojima! Kojima!
It is so good to see you. Thank you for joining us.
Big Dick Hideo Kojima.
First of all, I just want to ask, how are you doing? How are you feeling? How are things right now?
No, please, just show whatever's going on, please. Yep, I've heard about that. What is this, though? What's going on here? Is this Death Stranding related, or...?
Well, we certainly hope that you're going to get your vaccine soon. Let me ask you, as a...
It's a game about vaccines.
How has this past year impacted you?
Oh, that rum is so good. I have pineapple rum. It is so good. Alright, this is cool and all, but this is literally what I was just saying I didn't want. I'm not a fan of just people sitting around talking about things for ages. If you're gonna show video games, you know? Rather than just sit down with someone and chat for like half an hour. I can watch that another time, you know? These glasses are really cool. I like the shape of them. They look cool. Oh my god! Every year. Apart from last year, obviously, because that was different. But every other year. I always have to sit through a section of where they just talk randomly about random things. Just, if you're here to show off or talk about any game, just talk about the game. Like, just put this video up afterwards for anyone that's interested, should I say.
I don't know how much you can say, but can you give us any sense of...
I don't know if that motorbike's picking up right now. This one guy keeps going by on a moped scooter every day for the last, like, 2 weeks. He went past the other day when I was recording. It's in one of my videos, this guy just going past on a moped. And I'm like, really? Get on with it! For fuck's sake. I love Kojima, don't get me wrong, but I don't want to see two people sat in a room talking for like half an hour. The whole point is to be showing off games and to actually be giving proper details about games, not just an interview with a dude. I hate this. I just wanted to pause with this drink because I want to. Hell yeah. Ching! Oh, that's so good. I have pineapple Dead Man's Fingers rum. That's the brand.
And cola. It's so good. I really do appreciate you making the time to stop by and just say hello to everyone.
What was the point of that? I know you're like besties with him, but what was the point of that?
Jeff. Oh, one more thing.
Oh. One more thing, PlayStation. Come on, go on, trail, go. Oh, Oh, right. Death Stranding's coming to PS5, I'm guessing. Alright, that's cool. Can't wait for them to reveal that there's a bunch of new content coming only to PS5 so I can fucking scream and throw something at the fucking television. I actually hate Generations because I'm going to be missing out on a bunch of stuff for games that I love now, which really sucks. I really hate that. I really hate that there's going to be stuff for games that I love that I am not going to get to play now. Just because, oh, we've got to market it for the next gen. Fuck next gen. I hate generational crossovers. I'm already missing out on fucking DLC for Final Fantasy. Because, oh, you can only get the DLC on PS5. Fuck you. It just feels like a fuck you and a slap in the face to people that, like, that have supported those franchises. It's really annoying. Why couldn't this just be, yeah, we're bringing Death Stranding to PS5, not we're gonna... This is very Metal Gear-esque, and I kind of like it. Have they made a Metal Gear DLC for this? Because, don't get me wrong, I will get Death Stranding on PS5 again at some point. Well, when I actually have a PS5. I don't know why I said again. I'll only have bought it once, but you know what I mean. I mean, I'll have bought the game again. Orange, you glad I didn't say banana? I'm loving the parody of this trailer. What the fuck? What is going on? Sam, what are you doing? What are you doing, buddy? Okay, that was really weird. Is that Hideo Kojima trying to be like, I don't fit inside the box of Metal Gear anymore? Let me guess, it's just for PS5. Which, that doesn't make me happy, that just makes me annoyed, because I love that game. And now I'm not going to be able to play it because, oh, I don't have a PS5, so fuck you. Play has no limits, does it? Fucking Sony. I can't play that, can I? Unless I've got a PS5. Liars. I hope I make it into the director's cut. I'm told the full reveal is just weeks away. You're already in the game. What? I'm confused. Just a fox taking a break from work? Hell yeah. Oh, but it's a nice walk. Love good walks. Hell yeah. Mythic Quest? Oh. Thrilled to have him here at Summer Game Fest. Jeff Goldblum. Never mind. Alright. I don't know why I thought he mentioned something about a TV show. Okay.
I think it's Jeffrey. Hey, maybe it's Jeff. Hi, Jeff. Thank you so much.
That was weird, but okay. But how are you doing, Foxy? Hope you're having a wonderful freaking Thursday. Borderlands was indeed announced. So that was dope.
World premieres, as you say. And sure
Jurassic enough, Park, the video game. Well, there is. Again.
Yes, we do like our world premieres around here. Any chance you...
Jeff Goldblum is cool, but he's so weird.
Well, funny you should say that. Yes, you could say, yes, I do. If you don't mind, I've got something here. I'm going to read it on this. There's a little bit of a teleprompter that they're putting up here. So I'm going to read something because I don't want to get it wrong. I'm very meticulous about this. So here's a dramatic reading of this game announcement. Ready? I'm going to make the game announcement right now.
No, just do the game announcement. Stop pissing about.
I'm here to welcome you.
I hate this shit.
Very different world.
I like Jeff Goldblum, but I hate this shit. I hate when they get celebrity guests to do cringe things.
It's going to submerge you.
I thought you were trying not to be free.
Maybe even challenge you.
He is a bit. He does seem really awkward.
Chaos.
Control, now on PS5. Control, now on Switch.
Control, chaos.
Control, now on Nintendo DS.
So-called evolved. Take a look at the, you guessed it, world premiere.
Something evolved? Halo Combat Evolved. Hell yeah. It's Halo Combat Evolved, y'all. Let me guess, is this going to be Ark?
We ignored.
Oh, maybe not. Oh, so it is a Jurassic Park game. I was kidding, but okay.
Forgot the lessons.
Alright. Jurassic Park Combat Evolved. Master Chief just shows up.
With genetics, like it was a toy.
Also, you know what? Because I have drinks and I'm in a good mood, I'm going to toast everyone in chat. So, I've already done this for Artsling, but Foxy? Hell yeah.
Here we are.
If you don't have a drink, that's fine. Dinner. Master Chief! Oh. That logo's a bit naff for the evolution part, I mean. Just evolution 2. It's just a bit weird. I hear that game's good. Well, the first game's good, but I'm not really that bothered. PS5, PS4, Xbox Series X and S, and Xbox One.
Alright, this performer's new album, Jubilee, is out
now,
and her book, Crying in H-Mart, is a New York Times bestseller.
Alright, might have to mute this.
We are now to perform Glider from the upcoming open world game, Sable, by Raw Fury and Shedworks. It's Japanese breakfast.
Alright, gonna have to mute this part because it's gonna be potentially copyrighted. Oh, I remember that game. Yeah, that game looked really cool. The art style was, like, super pretty. Wow, who would have thought that she just started performing All Star by Smash Mouth? What a plot twist, I didn't see that one coming. Hey now, you're an All Star, get your game on, go Sable, hey now. What a plot twist. I kind of dig this. I mean, I know you can't hear it, but it's very nice. That game does look really cool, though. Also, she is slaying it right now, may I just say? Hell yeah. Companies aren't nearly greedy enough to fuck with something they already gave permission for. I just don't want to take any risks. I do remember Jeff Keighley. I think Jeff Keighley did say something about how there's like a copyright-free version of the stream that they were doing as well. This is just the normal version that I have. So, at least they're taking things into precautions. That's kind of cool. I love the art style for this, though. It looks really cool. I'm probably going to play this at some point. I might even stream it. That'd be cool. I'm just dancing to silence now, I realise. This is awkward. Pretty things. Pretty things on the screen. It's nice and peaceful, the song that she's performing. I guess if anyone wants to know what the song is, you can always look it up. They'll probably end up putting it on YouTube or something. Nice. But how are y'all doing today? I'm surprised I have the energy that I have right now because I'm actually quite tired today. I didn't sleep very well. I think I've just got the adrenaline going from the hype. It's E3 season and I'm excited. I love E3 season. I know it's nerdy as hell, but E3 season's my favorite time of year. Just all the video game related stuff. It's like, Alright. Silver Sable coming soon to Spider-Man.
Released on September 23rd
Hell yeah.
This year, that's some news for you. And to learn more about this amazing game, watch the Tribeca Games Showcase. That is tomorrow.
The what now?
Sable was named an official selection of the Legendary Festival. Now, today is just the start of Summer Game Fest. Day of the Devs with IM8Bit and...
Day of the Devs! That was good last year. I enjoyed that.
Today, and there are more events coming all weekend.
Play more Sayonara Wild Hearts music live. That was great last year.
Sunday, it's going to be a good one. Right now, though, we're thrilled to announce the upcoming Western release.
The what now?
Spectacular 3D massively multiplayer online role-playing game. Welcome to the world of Lost Ark from Smilegate RPG and Amazon Games.
Did he just say Smilegate RPG? Thank you for the host, Artlingity. Freaking appreciate it. Hells yeah. If there's actually a company called Smilegate RPG, that's the best name ever. I imagine it was Smilegate. I just thought it was funny. Thank you for the host as well, Foxy. Hell yes. Hell yeah. I don't know what my alerts are like these days. Might have been a bit quiet, actually. But I'm not sure. Did my computer just make a noise? My desktop suddenly started playing noise even though there was no alert. That's confusing. Alright, seems fine now, but that was confusing for a second then. I was slightly worried. Unless it was just a delayed alert noise. Is that a knife? You host and you come in here with a knife. That's some chaos right there. That's some chaos. God damn it! Sounds copyrighted, so I'm gonna mute that. I need to actually see if I can keybind my mute button just for my microphone. I don't know how you do that on Streamlabs. Would be really handy though. Why does that area just look like heaven from a or whatever it was called, from Diablo 3. Persona! Alright, there we go. That emote's pretty funny. I held my arms up, but I remember that my webcam kind of cuts my arms off, but I was like...
...play a game, there's that one thing in your inventory which turned out to be far more useful than you first realized. That's kind of like Prime Gaming. If you're an Amazon Prime member, most of you probably are, you get a ton of gaming goodies every month. Download Battlefield 4 and Batman the Telltale series completely free for PC.
And there are
special in-game benefits and perks, GTA Online, Valorant, Apex Legends, and more that you can unlock. It's awesome value.
He didn't say the D word. The game beginning with D that I was going to boo if he said it. I just want to know more about that Borderlands game. Like, why are they saying that we'll find out more over the summer rather than at the Gearbox event? Wouldn't that be, like, a good place to have that? It just seems really weird. I still not played the Telltale Batman games. Maybe I'll stream those one day, actually. That could be fun. I didn't even think about doing that. Because I have them on Xbox. Well, I have the first season on Xbox. I don't mind getting the second season, though, if I like the first one. Ooh, that artwork looks really cool. I started dancing as the music ended. God damn it.
Okay, right now I'm
God damn it.
Joined by Johanna Ferris, the new GM of Call of Duty. Johanna, it's so great.
The new Grandmaster.
Kickoff live. Everyone is so excited about what Call of Duty's been doing with all these seasons, and I know looks like next week,
well,
June 17th, season 4.
It seems like we're getting into the filler section of this.
Here, so thank you first and foremost to that. It's just such an amazing time for Call of Duty. We're experiencing such transformational growth and dynamism across the entire brand, you know, from premium title releases to everything we'll talk about today, with Warzone, with mobile, with esports. So it's
this sound, like, no offense to the lady, she's probably just doing her job, but this sounds so corporate. Like, the speech that she's trying to give, it sounds so goddamn corporate.
Now, who knows what's in store for season 4, but you guys, you know, continually update the game now with new stuff. Season 4 is coming next week. What can you, this is first info on it, so what
are
the fans watching around the world?
Yeah, we're stoked. It's jam-packed with new content. Across Cold War.
I tried Warzone. It was fun for, like, 5 minutes, and I was like, eh. It just feels like everything, every other battle royale that I don't care about.
Expanded zombies content for everybody who loves that part of, you know, the gameplay experience. So we're thrilled, and I'm excited to bring it forward a little bit here today.
I know we've got the first look. World.
So now to listen to one for it absolutely was Corporal Boosh.
Let's take a look at that now.
Corporal Boosh, I like that phrase. That reminded me of Cyberpunk. Goddamn corpos. That game was such a weird experience, though. Like, yeah, it was like broken as all hell, Cyberpunk, I mean. But I still somehow enjoyed it in a weird way. It was wild. It was definitely an experience, I can say that. Death Stranding content that I'm not going to be able to play. I hate the crossover to new generations. Because I'm one of those people that I'm never able to actually get next gen when it comes out. It takes a couple of years. So I end up missing out on so much stuff. And not being able to play it for years and years. It's the worst. What the fuck was that? That's a wrestling move. Oh god. Train of the Damned. Ugh. So now we're talking about esports. Great. My other favorite thing. Not. Duty.
What is the World Series of Warzone, which is going to start on June the 22nd. First of all, tell us, what is World Series of Warzone?
I'm sweating my ass off for this. It's really a new way for us to highlight... Much like Sonic 06 in that regard, you don't play it for the story or actually beating it. You play it for how broken you can make it before you beat it. Some games can be really fun. For that particular reason. Which is odd that that's a thing, but... sometimes it is, and sometimes it's really cool. Entails, but custom lobby experiences, 150 player, to a side squad. On a random note, I don't know if you're interested, but apparently there's going to be a Sonic Orchestra on this show or something. Looks like Twitch Rivals, which I should be able to leave on. I should be able to keep that on, so that should be cool. Certainly here with World Series of Warzone and partnering with Twitch Rivals, who's already done so much to really... just gotta check the form real quick, because Jess is currently traveling with her parents down south, so just want to make sure, like, see if she's gotten home yet. Fair enough. Right, am I the only person that thinks esports is massively overrated? I don't know why, I've never been a fan. Of esports. I just don't get it. I don't get it. I think it's just because I'm not really much of a competitive person when it comes to games, so I just don't care about any of this stuff. Some of these names, many of whom also hail from the Call of Duty League family. And I'm excited to see who kind of takes the cake here. We'll see. I was going to say they're all in just a couple weeks on Twitch Rivals. Well, it's really exciting to see how much Call of Duty is growing into this kind of. I recognize Tim the Tatman and Nade Shot, but that's about it. Lady on the left reminds me of Alexa Bliss a little bit. I don't know why. More details to share later on, but Sledgehammer. I don't know why. You know, going to bring forward something truly incredible, so we're excited.
All right, we tried, guys. There will come a time and a place for that. All right, Johanna, thank you so much for joining us. We really appreciate it. All right, we've got lots of Summer Game Fest kickoff to go, but right now we've got a surprise guest joining us, my fellow Canadian, Ryan Reynolds.
Cool.
Well, thank you, Jeff, and hello, Summer Game Fest. Now,
Ryan Reynolds, the video game. Drop it.
No,
do it.
I'm not here to announce. I'm the star of Elden Ring. I think.
Hitman, Wife, Bodyguard, whatever it's called. Oh, never mind. That's still not out? I thought that came out like years ago. Wow, it's been a wild time.
To be a, you know, lonely background character on an endless walk cycle. So, now here's one of those world premieres.
I might watch this at some point. Looks like it could be fun.
This August, and honestly, it's been so long.
Plus, with the cinemas opening again, I do want to go see... some movies, but I'm not sure what to go and watch. This might be one of them. I thought I had everything I needed.
Oh-ho! Mondays, am I right, Joe?
You said it, guy.
But then I met her.
Put these on.
Oh my god! What are these, trick glasses or something?
Guy, there is no easy way to say this. This world, it's a video game.
Gonna have to mute that because it's copyrighted music. Fuck my life. Hey, it's those guys. Both those guys. We have to fight together. I don't know why I'm happy right now, but I love it. And a kiss. I'm translating for you. You're welcome. That actually hurt my hand. I have three words for you. Suck it twice. Blue shirt guy. Ninjas in this, apparently. I've never seen anything like it. Who the hell even know who this guy is? Oh god, they put gamers in it. This is gonna be cringe. It's gonna be cringe. Everybody evacuate. Cringe alert. Probably still a fun movie, but cringe alert. I'm never gonna die, he said. Wait, ninja's racist now? When did this happen? I'm confused. I haven't heard about whatever that is.
Ryan had to say it. I can't say it yet. All right. Up next, it won multiple awards at the Game Awards, and Among Us just keeps going.
Oh, thank God. I was going to say, if this is Last of Us, I'm quitting the stream. I said, if this was the last, if they were like, Last of Us 2, I'll just switch the stream off and leave. Like, I'm done. I know they said they're adding a new color. I was like, all right, sure. I actually hope that they show Elden Ring, just for the people that want it. Because if they don't, and everybody complains about it not being there, I'm going to scream. This is all they'd let me show. Years ago, it evolved from racism to just being a piece of shit. Fair enough. I don't really know much about Ninja and other characters, what characters, not what I said, characters, I guess. I don't really keep up with any of that stuff anymore. I think I just kind of tune out of it. Let me guess, is it back? Yeah, it's back. Actually canonizing the Town of Us mod. Is that a Last of Us? An Among Us mod? I don't know anything about that game. I know absolutely nothing about that game, which is pretty suspect. It's pretty sus if you ask me, that I know nothing about that game. There you go, there's my cringe moment. You're welcome.
I'm very happy to welcome to Summer Game Fest the head of indies at PlayStation, a legend in his own right, who has some exciting things to share.
Okay.
Shuhei Yoshida.
Shuhei! The guy that looks like the friendliest man ever.
I'm Shuhei Yoshida, head of PlayStation Indies. What I love about working with independent developers are the new and unexpected games that they create, which allows us to offer an array of unique experiences for players. In my role at Sony, it's very exciting.
Absolutely massive mod that adds like 30 roles and modifiers. That's pretty cool.
Which sometimes can be one person or a small group of friends to help nurture the ideas and bring them to the PlayStation.
Nurture, great album by Port Robinson. Random shout out.
Who has been working with Greg Lobanov, the developer of Wondersong, to publish their new game, Chicory, A Colorful Tale. Chicory released today and gives players a chance to experience a coloring book style world.
That's pretty cool.
Where players use their painting powers to explore, solve puzzles, make friends, and draw on anything. Check out Chicory, A Colorful Tale on PlayStation 4 or PlayStation 5 after the show. As a huge Soulspawn games fan, I totally enjoyed the beautiful 2D action-adventure Salt and Sanctuary a few years ago. The developer Ska Studios has been hard at work on a new title, which I'm proud to present to you, Salt and Sacrifice.
Okay. Not my kind of thing, to be honest.
Our sins will catch up with us.
Basically more open Okami, also we got a remake of Okami. Wait, what? I'm confused. Always. I never actually played Okami. It's one of those games that seems really intimidating to get into. Ow.
I was given a second chance. I spoke the words.
The art style is kind of cool for this. Boing, boing.
I drank the mage bane. I live now.
Please, though. Tony Hawk Pro Skater 3 DLC for 1 and 2. Or separate. I'll buy it separate, but I feel like it'd work better as a DLC. But please, I want THPS 3 so bad. That's my favorite one. Even better if you could shadow drop it. I am a marked inquisitor. Just saying. Many of us. I wonder if there'll be any shadow drops today. Boom. Lots of stabbiness. Get your stab on. Stab and sacrifice. Or salt and stabrifice. Whichever one you prefer. Play has limits. Stop saying that, PlayStation. You're the one stopping crossplay.
Also able to share with you a brand new trailer from the upcoming Annapurna and Heart Machine game, Solar Ash, which is coming to PlayStation later this year.
Salt, I recognize that name. Have they shown this before? This game before, I mean? I recognize the name of Solar Ash. Oh, yeah, it was this game. Alright. Thought it was. Is that dragon made of drywall? What the fuck? Well, wings of drywall. I do like how colourful this game looks, though. It's pretty cool. Oh shit, we shadow the Colossus in this bitch. We're climbing all over it. I am going to stream Shadow of the Colossus at some point, by the way. I never played the game before. I have the PS4 version in my rent backlog. So I'm going to play that at some point. Kaboom! Okay. That was weird.
That looks so great. Can't wait to see it later this year. Now this week there is a ton of video game news.
Keely and his trainers. I only just noticed that.
Console and PC, Chivalry 2, which brings 64-player multiplayer medieval battles to life. Sledgehammers, swords, axes, you name it, and it comes from Torn Banner Studios in my hometown of Toronto, Canada. Here's a look at the launch trailer.
Oh, Canada!
Right now.
Every warrior, there comes a time when a moment will decide your fate. As the throng of battle echoes against steel and shield, as we cry out towards...
I'm not gonna lie, so far the only thing that's actually interested me is that Borderlands game at the start. A little disappointing for me personally, so far. Like I said, that's just me though, because different tastes in games and stuff. Damn. Brutal. Oh god. Who's Agatha? Tis blood but a flesh wound. Yeah, because medieval knights were diving off of ledges like that. That doesn't make sense. But sure, I guess. Not seen anything Game Pass related so far. Ugh. More arena shooters. Ugh. Alright, it's just a Prime thing, good. I don't want to hear more about esports. I'm tired of esports in every single fucking conference now. Believe it or not, they would? Hmm. Well, call me surprised. Oh, I don't care!
To whet your appetite with more to be revealed later this month during Summer Game Fest.
I really don't care about PvP games. I just don't. I'm already upset with Halo Infinite, which was the only PvP game I was actually interested in. Oh, okay, cool.
Told you it was very, very quick.
Oh, okay.
All right,
good.
PMC factions face off against each other in Escape from Tarkov, the popular multiplayer
first-person
shooter video game developed by Battlestate Games. Today, we've got an exclusive new look.
I'm about to Persona 3 myself out of this stream. I'm gonna call on my persona, Persona Freestyle, by blasting my head, basically, because Jesus Christ. I think I'm just at a point where I'm really tired of seeing arena or, like, PvP games all the time in these shows now. I get that they're popular, but I'm so bored. They all just look like the same thing every time to me, and I just do not care. Looks really nice graphically, though. I don't know what this is running on. Like, younger me would have loved games like this, but I think as I've grown, that was a mouse pointer, that was weird. As I've grown older and stuff, I just gotten to a point where PvP games just don't do it for me anymore. I don't enjoy them anymore at all. Like, at all. Unless it's friendly PvP, like if you're just playing with friends for fun, that's fine. But like, anything else, I just do not care. I really do not care. Surprise, motherfucker! Atsling, you doing a little look? Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Can't get it up anymore. What did I say again? I can't remember what I said for the context of that. Oh, they don't do it for me anymore. Yeah. You cheeky scamp! Cheeky, cheeky scamp. Can we move on now to the good stuff, please? To the good stuff, please. Move on to the good stuff, please. Now, that would be really nice. That would be really nice. Thank you. Hell yeah. Smug. Sorry, what?
On the fries in the theme park to increase your drink sales.
Oh.
So devilish. Well, many of the team members behind those sim games went on to create 2 Point Studios and 2 Point Hospital.
Oh, this is 2 Point Campus. Right, yeah.
Next 2 Point simulation.
I've not played 2 Point Hospital. I've got it downloaded, but I've not given it a try yet. I'm not the biggest fan of sim games, but I was going to give that a try.
The scent of a leather-bound book. The faint clatter of knights jousting.
Wow, that Chivalry 2 game's looking really weird.
Though it wasn't like this in my day. You see, campuses are forever changing. Nowadays, education has to be...
Hydration reminder.
It can't be all work and no play, and quite right too. Apparently, the results speak for themselves. Academia has never been more...
I remember my university days doing magic tricks. Pulling off magic spells and creating robots. What a good time that was. Burp.
Though sometimes you still can't get the staff. Yes, these days it really does feel as though anything is possible.
Ba-dum, 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 ba-dum. Looks kind of fun. I don't know if I'd actually like it or not, though. I'd probably have to play the hospital game first. I'm gonna sneeze, but I don't wanna. Okay, I'm good.
This year, I am.
All hail the cube!
Summer Game Fest. They have been doing an incredible job adapting games to series like Castlevania.
Announcing The Witcher Netflix show, The Game.
Tomorrow, I'm honored to be guest hosting Netflix's Geeked Week live stream with Mari Takahashi and Rahul Kohli. You can expect the first...
Still don't know what the fuck that is.
Show which, spoiler alert,
that's cool.
This show is going to be an absolute sensation. I can't wait for you to see it. I'll also sit down with the team behind Arcane, the League of Legends animated show coming later this year, and we might also have updates on The Witcher and the live-action Resident Evil series. Geek Week is streaming live tomorrow at 9 a.m.
Still don't know how I feel about that new Resident Evil show. They did an awful job with the films before.
What is Geek Week?
With the live-action films, so...
Virtual event full of big news, exciting first looks, and the people who make the shows and films you love...
League of Legends Animated? Yep, apparently. I won't be streaming that, by the way. I think this is tomorrow. The next thing I'll be streaming will be on Saturday. For the Wholesome Game Show, or the Wholesome Show, or something like that. Where apparently they're gonna... It's something to do with lots of wholesome, cute-looking games. Which sounds dope, so I'm gonna be checking that out. Saturday is gonna be chock-a-block. Yeah, I have three things to stream on Saturday. Wholesome Games, Devolver, and Gearbox. I'm going to be streaming from 6 p.m. till past 10. So like maybe like 11 o'clock. It is going to be a wild, wild evening.
Last summer we announced the Avatar The Last Bender one. Well, as Smite enters its ninth year, it's time to go upside down.
Wait, what? Smite's going to ha... Alright, sure. Whatever. Sure, I guess. What a bizarre crossover. I love Strange Things though. It's just a really weird crossover. It's Young Jack from Mass Effect. Eleven looks really weird like that. I don't know why. She looks really weird. Eleven, what now? Ha! Yo, what up? The second outfit! Yes! That's pretty funny. That is the weirdest crossover, but okay.
We announce a lot of games.
Fair enough.
Shows, but I think this is the first time we are announcing an entirely new game label, new game publisher.
Okay.
Enjoy this first look at more than 12.
Is it Kingfish Games? Is my studio finally hitting off? From that one video that I made last year.
Sometimes I ask myself what it all means. Let's begin.
Oh hell yeah, it's Badass Smoking Dude, my favorite character. Oh, is that a... Wait, what? This is weird. I'm confused.
Is that who you are?
My purpose makes me who I am.
I don't know what that game is, with the cool, like, dude in the sunglasses.
I have a feeling we're doing something worthwhile.
Being relied on to succeed where others would fail.
So, is that saying that they now own all those companies, like Overkill?
There you have it, Prime Matter, Payday 3, 2, and there is actually one more game added to the mix, and for that we go to Todd Hollins.
Wait, what? Payday 3, 2?
I'm great, Jeff. Thank
is that what, did you say Payday 3, 2?
I decided to have this little last edition, which is that Saber... Oh,
2-T-O-O, I thought you meant the number, I was really confused. That's kind of cool, though. I'd play it if the console version was actually any good. Do not like the console versions of those games, they are not very good. They do not feel very good, and the servers were a constant nightmare. But I'd play it though.
It's coming this fall only to Xbox, PC, and Game Pass on day one. It's called the Anacrucis, a four-player cooperative first-person
game. Oh, for fuck's sake! It's multiplayer! I can't win anything anymore! It's all multiplayer these days! Unlock perks, weapons, and new ways to play. Never mind. Here is the world premiere. This showcase feels like everything that I don't play. Basically, the Borderlands game is like the one thing. I'm kind of getting Left 4 Dead vibes. But, like, aliens, obviously. I mean, like, if I had people to play these kinds of games with, I totally would. Cooperative, I have no problem with. I love cooperative games, but I just don't have people to play them with anymore, so I tend to stick to single player related games. The Anacrucis.
We call them tanks.
I call them brutes.
That's a weird name.
Brutus.
We'd sound smart.
It's kind of cool.
Brutes.
Eon, you don't want to get in here and help name these?
No, I'm good.
Brutes!
The guy on the right looks like he's in Fallout. That's weird. Obviously, lost a lot of data at one point, couldn't upgrade anything, had to bankrupt the reorganized, failed to get out of the red, and brought in new splitting management. Interesting. I think I remember hearing something about that. About a while ago. Oh, why does my arm hurt?
Oh. Game director Scott Lane will take players into the mysterious supernatural island that is a world of wonder and horror. Once you arrive, it's up to you to unite warring human factions to take on a common enemy.
Is this the game that everyone's annoyed about because of microtransactions? Or is that a different game I'm thinking of?
Five-player challenges with unique mechanics, bosses, loot, and more.
Because if the game has microtransactions, I'm just not going to play it. I detest microtransactions. And cash shops, for that matter. Fuck cash shops.
The game and the team's efforts over the past year in the midst of COVID. It is exciting for me to finally be able to get out there and visit game studios again. I miss all these developers. So check out the special deep dive stream on
Game
World tomorrow at 8 a.m. Pacific,
11 a.m. I won't, but fair enough.
SummerGameFest.com. Alright, well, back in 2018, Rocket League teamed up with Fast and Furious, bringing some of the saga's most iconic cars into the game. Now, they are back, with a twist that is truly Rocket League, with Fast 9, the next installment of the...
Is Michelle Rodriguez still playing Tekken Fighter?
Psyonix is bringing back the Nissan Skyline, Dodge Charger, and, well, maybe the most literal, supersonic, acrobatic, rocket-powered heist car ever conceived. The F9 Pontiac Fiero.
That meant nothing to me, but okay. I want to cry right now. A lot of this has been really, really, really not very fun for me. Remember when this series used to be a gritty crime, kind of like a crime drama? I remember.
Seems like the right idea to me. The Fast and Furious three-car bundle arrives June 17th in Rocket League. Okay, next up, last year, a new Swedish company named Shark Mob released a teaser for their first unnamed multiplayer project in the Vampire the Masquerade universe. Tonight, we're putting a name on their first game with a brand new world premiere trailer.
All right, more multiplayer stuff. That's great. Why don't I just call it Multiplayer Game Fest? Because that's what it fucking feels like right now. Whatever happened to Vampire the Masquerade 2? Did that get cancelled? Or is it just in development hell, apparently? Because, not heard about that for a long time.
Secrecy among you. May
I never played the first Vampire the Masquerade. I'm not gonna lie, I didn't like the look of it. We have influenced your society. Maybe I need to play it for myself to truly get like a grip on it, but I don't know. New management also closed out a lot of old glitched overkill couldn't deal with. Including the one that absolutely broke the leveling system. That's pretty cool. It's good to see they've been doing good work then. Sorry, I do realise I think I missed that comment. I mean, on the plus side, even if this ends up being the most boring thing ever, for me, at least there's still more stuff in the next few days to come. So all will not be lost.
I can't wait to play this game, and we actually won't have to wait long. You can sign up now. The bloodhunt.com is where you go for the closed alpha PC test available on July 2nd. Bloodhunt will be.
My nose is running right now a little bit, and it's bugging me.
Next, the latest horror game series from the creators of Until Dawn continues with the House of Ashes.
All right. Dark Pictures Anthology. I've not played these games because I'm a little baby bitch, so I can't play them myself. But I have watched people play these games. They're really cool.
With the exclusive reveal of the monster.
So all right.
Lurking.
Also, warning, there might be jump scares, because these games usually have jump scares and stuff, so I just figured I'd mention, if anyone doesn't like jump scares, Jesus Christ, then you've been warned, just in case. I'm closing that glitch has made leveling hell, because it takes so long to do nowadays, unless you have friends playing the crime spree mode with you. Dang. I always liked the look of Payday, but didn't have people to play it with, which affected my enjoyment. And then the Xbox version, at the very least, the aiming felt absolutely awful. It felt really sluggish and slow. It just didn't feel very good. And then, and then the servers were constantly having issues when I tried to join up with other people. So I eventually just gave up playing. I've tried playing the Xbox version twice, and I have the same issues every time. So I was like, ah, I'm good. Which is a shame, because it does look like a really cool game. I'd love to be able to play that with people. Like, I feel like that would be one of those games I'd really enjoy playing with people.
You teeter on the edge of an abyss. Your survival depends on the choices you make.
Did he just fall in someone's mouth? That was weird. That was real weird. Did I turn up sensitivity? I think I experimented with it to have a look around for a while, but it just... I think it's because the aiming on console was delayed. I can't play games that have delayed aiming because it just doesn't feel right to me. Like, I struggle enough with that in Far Cry games because of the delay. I'm a Halo fan, what can I say? The Xbox One's actually unfinished. Well, I mean, the console's unfinished. I had to leave a little dig towards the Xbox One in there. I fucking hate that console. Well, how's it unfinished, by the way? I'm curious. So my brain is like struggling to try and talk while I've got like the audio in my ear at the same time of like what was going on in that. Oh heck. Oh shit. Can't wait to watch the Scurry Game Squad play that. That's pretty cool. It's really odd though, the selling them all separately. JRPG franchise Dragon Quest?
The Tales of series.
Oh.
Well, the latest game, Arise, was announced 2 years ago, and it brings the franchise...
Ending isn't in that whatsoever, and it missed a lot of DLC. I remember hearing some of that, I know you mentioned the new management, but the original management apparently really didn't like making stuff for consoles, and said, I think there was like a statement that one of the reasons that I got put off the game was because one of the devs said, screw consoles, we don't give a shit about that, basically. Like, if you want to play the full game, come to PC instead. And I was like, really, dude? It was totally just one dude who said that, but I was like, really, dude? And that kind of put me on a bad path with that game. With a balance and jeopardy.
Should you need my skills on the battlefield, all I care for is maintaining peace.
I thought the Tales of Ceres was a kind of like turn-based. Or am I wrong on that? Am I thinking of something else?
When I fight to protect my dream.
Well, this crew just gets bigger and bigger.
The Renans. Seems the rumors you were running with them were true.
I'm not the biggest fan of JRPGs, to be honest. Pokemon is like the only one that I can fully enjoy. I've been struggling with Yakuza Like a Dragon because I do really enjoy that game, but the combat is kind of eh to me. That was the other reason the management got changed. CEO was not happy when they... I can imagine. I can imagine.
Is it over? It's only just begun.
Ow. Tales of the Rise. Or if you want to be fancy, Arise. Tales of Arise. That was a weird cut, but okay. What's this? Looks cute.
For Summer Game Fest, we have a special announcement for you.
Okay.
That the console version of Sky Children of the Light would arrive to Nintendo Switch on June 29th. And the Little Prince season would start soon after on July 6th.
Why does the character in the red cape remind me of the Rootles from Legend of Zelda Wind Waker, kind of. It looks kind of cool. I'm intrigued.
One of the things I take great pleasure in is using a platform like this show to introduce you to new developers and studios with games that deserve the spotlight. That's definitely the case with this next title from a small Swedish studio named Wishfully. Planet of Lana tells the story of a young girl and her loyal friend who embark on a mission through a colorful world that's designed to feel like a gouache watercolor painting come to life.
A what now?
Your first look at the Planet of Lana coming to Xbox and PC in 2022.
Is that Xbox? That's me. Well, I mean, I have a PS4 as well, but you know what I mean. It's my main platform for some reason. Ooh, that's pretty. That's one of the things I've noticed with a lot of indie games. Is indie games really embrace art styles, and I really love that. Like, there's a lot of games these days, even that House of Ashe, for instance. I think it was called House of Ashe. They're all just are trying to look super realistic all the time. So it is nice to get games like this that don't look like that, you know. Are they like drop pods or something? Thunderful and Wishfully present. This looks cute. I like this already. I think we're finally at my section. It's suddenly mastered. I was thinking it, but I thought, nah, I've made that joke too many times. I'll leave it. Oh, heck. That's a big beastie. Planet of Lana. An off-Earth Odyssey. Sounds pretty cool. I don't remember if they mentioned Game Pass with this. If this is on Game Pass, I'll definitely have a look at this. It sucks being poor. I have to rely on Game Pass so much. 2022. Wishlist now on Steam. I don't see Game Pass. Fuck my life. Alright. I look cool though. I like that. That was nice.
What a beautiful artistic game.
Oh god, please don't have like half an hour of talking again.
Who's the game director of Overwatch 2, Aaron? Great to have you here.
Otherwise I'm going to scream.
Thank you so much for having us here.
Yeah, we are excited to learn more about what's planned for Overwatch 2. You guys recently, you had a PvP...
Overwatch 2, Overwatch Boogaloo.
Some changes coming to Overwatch 2. What can you tell us? What's the latest?
Yeah, so we recently announced that Overwatch 2's format is changing to a 5v5 team format. This requires a fresh look at all of our heroes in the game. It should feel new yet familiar to fans of our strategic team-based combat.
That could potentially bite them in the ass. I remember when Destiny decided to change from 6v6 mods to 4v4, and for whatever reason, most people really hated that.
Yeah, the team is so passionate about updating the...
But that's Destiny, and the PvP is literally the worst thing ever made in terms of PvP. So, whereas Overwatch doesn't seem like it's a bad PvP, so...
Two of those, Baptiste and Sombra.
All right, well, let's take a look here, and I know you're going to tell us a little bit about what we're seeing, but it's so cool to see these characters brought into Overwatch 2. So, yeah, what do we got here?
Yeah, so this is Baptiste, and there's a lot of new technology that go into our models. We have new hair shader tech, in order to get the look that we're
sure
going
haters.
He also has
sure hater technology
gloves that kind of give that medic or surgeon vibe to him.
I do really love the character designs for Overwatch. I just do not care about Overwatch. I own the game on PC. Didn't really enjoy it much. Just thought it was another PvP shooter with lots of toxic people screaming the N-word over the headsets constantly. So I was like, nah, I'm good.
And nodes embedded in her clothing. She's a world-class hacker, so it all makes sense.
No, again, it's, you know, so great for fans to see these characters you know and love from the first game updated for Overwatch 2, and we can't wait to see more on.
I was really hoping we were done with the multiplayer game, so, but oh well.
You bet, thank you.
Awesome, alright, thanks very much, Aaron.
Dude named Charge of Overwatch 2 is in a Activision. With the game developer Jeff Haddam, oh, for fuck's sake.
Ember Moon from the WWE. That's right.
Ember Moon? Alright, I like Ember Moon. Is an Activision kiss ass the previous guy? No. I'm really struggling to read while Jeff's talking to me for some reason. The guy, no matter what can be said against him, did at least stance against some of the shitty changes actually and what he's made. Wild. Wild. Yeah, Ember Moon apparently is something to do with this. Queen! Okay, sorry. Had to. I know of him as well, but I just don't know as much about him.
Oh no, you get that.
A warrior's death, I died again.
I'm coming to get you.
Hey, hey, hey.
Oh. Watch it.
Oh.
Oh no. Oh no, I can't believe I'm down. I'm down, people.
The developer's down?
The dev
what?
Is down.
So, Ember, I know you really wanted to be Drift,
absolutely.
Right?
I've
Jeff's intense game face.
I'm disconnected with it on such an intimate level to the point where my wrestling character that everyone sees on TV is actually based on this character. The red eyes, even though Driss has purple,
I call
I just
that
love everything about him, that he's just
I'm confused.
Constantly the good guy the entire time.
Oh.
I really don't like my memory problems because I can say something and literally forget what I said 2 seconds ago. It's wild.
Let me see what you got. You ain't got nothing on us, baby.
I'm here now.
I spoke way too soon.
We got him, we got him. He's gone.
I love how Ember Moon is in like full get up just to play this game. Oh, you yelled queen. Ah, right, right. I get it now. I get it now. Hey! I like that. That's pretty funny. But I get it now. Queen! I do not know how much I peak my microphone doing that. That's why I try and lean away when I do that. Oh my god, I'm going to... Jeff, why? I hate this! This is the most... Oh my... It's just multiplayer game after multiplayer game. I wanna die. Oh my god. I think I am. Jesus. Oh god. Can we get not multiplayer games now, please? Please? Like, please? Please?
Of the next Battlefield from EA and you want to dust up on the history of the franchise.
Might as well get it out now, because that's all it's gonna be. Yeah, you're probably right. You know what? I keep forgetting. This is Jess's pillow. It's from Friends, if you don't know what that is. I can scream into this. That's what I'll do. That's what I'll do. Also, what's that emote? I have to have a look. Cute! I like the red jacket. It's pretty nice.
Right now, if you are an Amazon Prime member. And this Sunday, watch the Xbox and Bethesda Game Showcase.
I will be there. Not literally. I will not literally be there, right now, but I will be streaming that event. I'm excited for that. Hunter Stories is coming to the Switch in July. Alright, I'm good. I know, like, this is kind of multiplayer, I know, but it can be played solo. I don't really care about Monster Hunter. I tried Monster Hunter World, I was really bored playing it, just not my kind of game at all. Not saying it's a bad game, just saying it's not my kind of game. Didn't even follow that channel until I got a sub last night, but I'm not complaining. That happens all the time to me. I actually had a sub from a channel I don't follow run out today, like before the stream. Oh, I need to burp. Alright. Just because for some reason I was reminded of it, does anyone think we're going to hear anything about Breath of the Wild 2 at Nintendo's event? We can't let you interfere with our plan. When's Nintendo's event again? Nintendo's event... Oh wait, I forgot to say that earlier, I skipped that by accident. I will also be streaming the Nintendo event, June the 15th at 5 p.m. So 5 days from now. But I really, really hope we hear something about Zelda. And if it is true about the Switch Pro, it better just be like an upgraded Switch and not like a, we're going to start making games exclusively for this because of Soul, fuck you, Nintendo. Because we just got a Switch. You're going to be born, huh? What a weird line. What a cute outfit. What an even cuter outfit. I don't know who that person is, but they're adorable. That's pretty cool. I'm still surprised that Capcom are having an event.
Legendary rock band hits the road this summer on the Hella Mega Tour with Green Day and
with Green Day. But first they came together with all right. Wait, what?
Stream safe music for the community. Yes, you can co-stream this performance. So turn it up. Premiering their brand new
Sure, let's test it.
Tell me what you want.
What you really, really want. So tell me what you want, what you really, really want. I wanna really, really, really want no more multiplayer games. Apparently it's safe, they said it. I'm gonna test it. If it's too loud, let me know. Okay. What's this game? You know what? I have dance emotes. If you have any dancing emotes, just put them in the chat. We'll buggy is what we'll do. I'm just gonna vibe. Thanks, I'd love it. Can I have you? Give me your guitar. You just said I could have your guitar. Can you pass it? Can you pass it over here, please? It's pretty nice. Dude. Hello. Dude. All right. You can't hear me. Yeah, what is this game actually? It looks kind of cool. That is a cute emote. Oh yeah, Kasuga, yeah, works now. Hell yeah. FYI, if there are any BTTV emotes you want me to add, feel free to let me know. I can find something to replace. Tony Hawk Pro Skater 3! Did you get that? Did you write that down? I just want to check. Did you... I've forgotten the name of the lead singer, but... Rivers Cuomo! Did Tony Hawk Pro Skater 3, did you... He can't hear me. He can't hear me. He can't hear a word I'm saying. He's playing too loud. He just can't hear me. That's me. I'm in this. I'm not water. That's me. Right, it's kind of nice, this is, I don't mind Weezer. I do wish that if they have performances by bands and things like that, I feel like it should be video game music. Like if they had, here's the Persona 5 band or whatever, to perform Last Surprise from Persona 5. Stuff like that, the Game Awards usually gets that pretty good. But just random celebrity guests playing music, a lot of people are probably not going to give a shit about this. Unless they like Weezer. It's going to be a very niche, whatever the word is, kind of thing, where only the fans are going to care about this. Compared to, I don't know, I just love hearing video game music. I get hyped for that shit.
Thank you, Rivers and guys, for that. Both the song and the game released tomorrow on PC, Nintendo Switch.
What's the game?
Streaming platforms, Twitch soundtrack.
Did they say what the game was? I don't even know what the game is. It looked kind of cool, but I don't know what it was.
A game that we announced last
oh my god.
Game Awards. Endless Dungeon from Amplitude. We
showed a damn it, damn it.
In December and fans wanted more.
Well, damn it, damn it, I know you. It's another one of these games.
Until everybody learns the rules. Yep, all of them. Rule number one. Certain weapons work better on certain monsters. Learn it. Or die.
The art style's cool, I'm not a fan. I'm pretty sure this is a roguelike from what I remember, and roguelikes are one of the biggest trends that I am just not a fan of. I don't like roguelike games, they're too stressful. I don't have fun with quite a lot of them. As some of you may know, I don't like losing progress in video games. Oh, I've gotten salty over that so many times on stream, good god.
Yep, just like that.
I'm really warm right now. Those emotes are so cute! There's a pride lion? That's pretty cool.
If you fight alone, you die alone. Together again. And rule number four? Well, if you've got all that going, but you still can't win, you gotta change the squad. Tag team.
This is music's nice. Oh, I love seeing that Sega logo because of the Yakuza franchise now. I fucking love the Yakuza franchise.
Probably getting ready to play Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart. I've been playing it.
Have fun, anyone that's going to be playing that. The technology looks insanely cool.
Special launch stream on Twitch, and to tell us more, take it away, Marcus and Mike.
Hey Jeff and everybody watching Summer Games Fest.
They got Marcus and they've got Mike. Where's Matthew? Rude.
Games for Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart. We're excited that players finally get a chance to play the game tomorrow, and to celebrate, we want to spend some more time with you today. At 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern.
It does look like a really pretty, really impressive game.
Isn't that right, Mike?
I've never been a fan of those kinds of games.
In addition to playing,
I think I've come to discover just watching this, there's a lot of stuff I don't like to do with video games. There's a lot of kinds of video games that I just am not interested in, apparently. I feel like a video game hipster and I don't like that. I don't like that.
We're now about to be joined by the one and only Giancarlo Esposito to talk Far Cry.
Esposito.
Thank you for joining us. So why did you want to take on this role?
They came to me with this phenomenal idea
and had proposed that I play Anton Castillo, the leader of Yara, with this big vision and dream for his country. And it really appealed to me because he was a guy who...
See, I like the Far Cry games. I'm kind of interested in this, but I utterly despise Ubisoft as a company. So I don't know if I'll end up playing this. I certainly won't be buying it.
The other part of it is it's just a different technology that's so brand new. It excites me as a filmmaker that I want to be a part of it.
All right, well, you've played some absolutely amazing villains in your career. What was it like being a video game villain?
No, I'm not a villain. I got to push back on you. I'll let you finish. But this guy loves his country. He wants to empower you, Keely. He wants to empower you to stand up and speak your truth. Now, you can go back to calling me a villain if you like.
Well, you are okay. Smiling on the box. You're a good guy, right?
I am, because I feel like we as human beings fall in line, and I want to be a renegade within reason. How do you like that? Because I think part and parcel of us falling in line and doing what we need to do and thinking about the cumulative effect of our doing what's right, and the example of that is also to stand up and say, no, I do agree that they're good and bad about all people, but this guy, out of his love and passion for his people, even if they're faceless to him at certain points in time, allow him to be an absolute hero.
Speaking of your character, who did you base him on or study to create this character?
It's so interesting because, of course, the obvious choice to study is Fidel Castro. It is Cuba, an island that had so many resources, but really the dream of the ability of the dictator to cultivate those resources, something got in the way there. And hopefully that can change in the years to come. Funny you asked me that question, because
I was hoping this would be more interesting, this whole show, so far quite a lot of it's been quite dull, to be honest. He did mention that there is apparently one big thing to talk about at the show, which is probably going to be like the end of the show, but it's probably Elden Ring. I wouldn't be surprised.
And studied political science and all this. So anyway.
All right. Well, one last question.
Can we just keep these celebrity sections for after the show? Just,
you know, and I have
put them up on YouTube or something as an extra thing. I hate this in E3. I hate this at GameFest. I hate this at any conference. It really, really messes with the flow of things.
I think Gus is colder. And
good old Gus Fring.
Coldness in a very particular way. I think Anton could be the most violent man on Earth. But given his situation, he may not rise to that occasion or may not have the time. Moff Gideon is otherworldly. This guy...
You're otherworldly. Got him!
Before you say it. And he does all his own dirty work. And he has... incredible tool to help him out.
So my OCD apparently is just kicked in and feels
fair
the need
enough.
To
all right, John Carlo, thank you so much for hanging out with us.
Sort out my surroundings.
Check out the revolution basically. In Far Cry 6.
And I can't wait for it to begin. Let the games begin!
Awesome. All right, thank you so
He's
much.
Very happy to be here, apparently.
Yet. Prime Gaming unlocks a ton of in-game benefits for Amazon Prime members, like an exclusive Valkyrie skin in Apex Legends.
Really? You get gaming stuff on Amazon? I did not know, Jeff. And Fall Guys, that's the first I've heard.
Burning Circuits costume for your bean through June 21st. Now, speaking of Fall Guys, the time has come to reveal a brand new costume coming to the game based on a legendary game franchise. Check it out.
I'll admit though, I did like Fall Guys when I played the beta. Oh, that's cursed! That's cursed! In the best kind of way! Fall off the stage and win lots of crowns. In Fall Guys Ultimate Knockout. I couldn't get into Genshin Impact. I played it for a little while, for a couple of days. It just felt like Breath of the Wild, but not really that good in comparison. I was just like, yeah, okay. And then I got kind of tired of it, but oh well. Soul Cursed, I love it. I actually do love that. I think that's fucking funny. I would not have guessed that in a million years. I would not have guessed that it would have been Neo.
Organizing the clash is my way of uncovering hidden talents. And hopefully this time, getting a vision.
So is this like an expansion or... or just new characters? Sounds like an expansion. Also, that game's a gacha game, so I was immediately put off by that. Why doesn't it say is it only PS5, PS? Oh yeah, so it is. Never mind.
A publisher, Prime Matter, so why not announce a developer too?
Is that fucking Jason Blundell? Yeah.
Deviation Games.
I remember him from my Call of Duty Zombies days. Weird.
What can we expect from your new studio, guys?
Well, thanks, Jeff. And look,
why
Jeff
is he so loud?
We've been mates for donkey's years.
And for donkey's years. Gotta love the English. The English phrases. Hell yes.
Huge franchises. You know,
hell yes.
You know, they've done well. And but we thought, you know, when you're working on those franchises, the long-established IPs, you're working within very, very tight constraints creatively about what you can do. So we thought, after all these years, you know, what if we deviated?
Yes.
So that's Deviation Games.
Okay.
So,
okay.
Jeff, just trust me, all bets are off. From right. Day one, we got complete financial security to work with creative freedom and time, not just to make a brand new IP, which is what we're doing.
To me, this sounds like they're saying, we were sick of Call of Duty. We were sick and tired of making the same game all the time. Although, I don't know if the guy on the left was from
it's the best idea that
any of the studios for Call of Duty, but the guy on the right was.
Well, big ideas from you guys, as we would expect. Now, I know it's very early, and there is nothing to show on the game today, but can you tell us a bit about...
Then please hurry up and move on. I'm really, really hate these bits where they just stand there and talk to people for ages. I know I'm probably impatient for saying that, but I want to actually see the games that these people are talking about. Not, this game's going to be the greatest thing of all time. It's going to be amazing. It's going to be wonderful. I'm going to throw 50,000 buzzwords at you, and then we're going to leave, and you'll still have no fucking clue what the hell we were just talking about. Like, just get on with it. Come on!
Excited about it. There is one more piece of the puzzle, though, that you want to reveal today.
Okay.
That, let's take a look at this.
It's Nier Automata. Nier Automata is now in this company. You can get it. They're all going to wear the costume while they make the games. It's PlayStation exclusive. Shuya.
Okay, big news. The stage has changed. Blue of PlayStation, so you're partnering with PlayStation.
Right.
What can you tell us about that partnership?
That's right, Jeff. And the partnership with PlayStation, it's all about quality. From soup to nuts, this project is all about quality. And our team of deviators that we have back in the studio...
I need the pillow again.
We are so proud of you.
God, I don't love it! All right.
The partnership with Sony, it's very, very simple.
I mean, all right.
God, just look at the track record of consistency and quality games that they do. Hit after hit.
Guess I never miss, huh?
And now we've been part of this process and we see how they do things.
I know he said hit after hit, but I don't care. I'm making a joke anyway, because I'm bored!
More proud.
Expand
PlayStation's portfolio, which we're going to do in a...
I'm going to need a lot more of this.
I mean, let's just face it, right? Sony rocks, and they get our kind of brand of crazy, so we're very happy with this partnership.
All right, so...
Please tell me you were paid to say that, Jason Blow, because PlayStation does not rock. They are assholes. They make some great games, sure, but they're still assholes.
Awesome. All right, Dave, Jason, thank you very much.
Well,
all right. Well, this year
certain people within PlayStation, obviously. Okay, this is the orchestra, I think. I'll listen to this. Like I said, video game music, I'm cool with that. Even though I'm not a Sonic fan, I will listen to this. Because, okay, fuck, I don't know anything about Sonic Unleashed. I was kind of hoping for, like, original games, but oh well. But there you go. I'll leave it on. Is it a bit quiet? I just want to make sure it's not drowning me out. I'll turn it up just a teensy bit, just to see. Because I need to make sure it's not going to drown me out if I'm saying anything. You know what, it's more so just listening anyway. I'll crank it up a bit. Should be fine. I'll see how it goes. Why do I recognize this song? I've never played this game before. Why does that look like The Last City or whatever it's called from Attack on Titan? Jaeger! Sorry, Sega! What a dumb fucking joke, but alright. I'll shut up now. Getting an Unleashed remake? Nice. I'll admit, I'm not really a Sonic fan. I don't know what it is, I've just never really gotten into Sonic games. Drag on. Last City was based on Italy or Spain. That's pretty cool. What? What's the point then? Oh my god. This has been the dumbest thing. Alright, finally, something I can be interested in. Alright, let's turn that back down a bit.
At the zombie multiplayer fun of Back for Blood. And right now we've got a quick tease of a new boss and news on the beta.
Because I'm too slow. I just don't know how to go fast. I don't know how to go fast. Which is ironic because I'm really impatient as a person. I actually am looking forward to this because I did really enjoy Left 4 Dead. The only issue that I'm having, like I said, is that I don't really have people to play games with much these days. So I don't know how this is going to go for me. Fucking copyrighted songs! But I am looking forward to seeing how this turns out. For anyone who's unaware, this game is basically... It's basically Left 4 Dead. Hence the title of Back 4 Blood. Because it's just another Left 4 Dead, but it's not Left 4 Dead, if you know what I mean. It's the same kind of gameplay style with some of their own changes and stuff.
One of the things I'm most passionate
about. But yeah, I'm looking forward to that.
Guys, access to play more games at home. Last year, Steam.
Oh, we're doing this again?
Incredible demo events around summer games.
That was cool last year.
Steam's Next Fest starts next Wednesday, and Xbox is back again to do an ID at Xbox demo event, which I'm announcing right now.
Nice.
It starts on Tuesday, and it's completely free. No badges required. One of the games I'm most excited about in the lineup is Tunic from my fellow Canadian Andrew Scholdice. Here he is to give you.
Are we finally getting Tunic? Finally, after like a bajillion years? Me and Jess have been wanting to play this game since they first announced it in like fucking 1924. Which is an isometric. Finally! Yes!
Where you explore the wilderness, fight monsters, and find secrets. I first started working on it about 6 years ago. It's been changing a lot over the years.
I mean, I don't know when it's actually going to come out, but at least we can play something of it.
So in Tunic, you start the game and you are a little fox that's washed up on a beach. And you don't have a whole lot of context except for, you know, a lust for adventure. And you are going to wander off and maybe you're going to find a stick.
Ah, I clapped my hand too hard.
Further, maybe you're going to find
it hurts now.
It's really about that sense of discovery.
Ow.
Wondering what's around the next corner. People have played the game at shows before, but we wanted to put together a brand new demo that was, you know, for the home audience, and so it's full of never before seen stuff, a brand new dungeon.
I might stream this. People haven't seen before. I think this is supposed to be coming to Game Pass.
So excited about Tunic, and Sable also is going to be.
But when it comes out, I mean, I don't know how long the demo will be, so.
Next,
hell yeah.
Stave off Ragnarok in this ancient Norse-inspired co-op action survival RPG that you can also fully play solo. Classic hack and slash gameplay.
All right. Norsefell's tribe. You said solo. I can't complain.
PlayStation and PC, July 27th. Here is the brand new trailer.
Ragnarok.
Come to Midgard.
and you have been chosen by the gods to protect this realm. But your first task is to find some new clothes that aren't as drafty. Your tribe's journey starts in the wilderness. Hunt down pets, gather rare resources, and explore the untamed world. Once you've plundered all you can carry, return to your...
I mean, it looks like it could be fun solo, but I don't know.
You must protect the seed of Yggdrasil.
Looks pretty though. I like the art style.
And everything in it will be destroyed forever. So take heed. The Helthings rise when the sun sets. Destroy these dark spirits before they destroy the seed. Each victorious night makes way for a new day to venture
the new day. The new day confirmed for this game. The new day are gonna be in this game. I'm joking. I'm joking.
But be careful.
But could you imagine? That'd be cool.
Craft legendary weapons, build deadly defenses, and grow the strength of your tribe, because those giants are on their way. And it's time for us to end their path of destruction. Let's show them our might is greater than their height. As the saying goes, Valhalla!
Oh wait.
Oh.
I've never heard that said before, but okay. That's cool artwork. Nice. Ew! Don't put a pre-order bonus on that shit. That's how you get me to fucking not play.
Evil Dead. We announced this game last December.
I don't know what this is. I can't remember what this is. Like what the game actually is. Should I say? I know what Evil Dead is, obviously.
Tim Willits from Saber.
Hi Jeff, it's great to see you. Today we have
wow, that Iron Man statue in the background
of the Evil Dead the game.
That's huge.
We are excited to show you this, and to help me explain it is Bruce Campbell.
And that Hellraiser statue, that's pretty dope. He's got some cool collectibles. Hell yeah. See, I'm not sure what this game actually is. I don't know if it's like a cooperative level-based game, like where you play levels or something, or if it's something like Dead by Daylight. Okay, it's not Dead by Daylight then. It's not like Dead by Daylight then.
Cyber friends, I'm Bruce Campbell. You know me as Ash Williams.
Hell yeah, I do. I also know you as that dude that shows up in all of the Sam Raimi Spider-Man films. Good old Bruce Campbell. Good old Bruce Campbell indeed.
You and your friends will team up as classic Evil Dead heroes to live the nightmare. You'll use savage finishing moves or tear evil a new one. Or, if you're not into the whole save the world thing, we have another option. You can play as the vile Kandarian demon itself.
But okay.
You don't want to do that. You'd be a dick. With the power possession in your arsenal, you'll scare those goody two-shoes to death. Literally, you can do that if you're a dick. Whether you choose the path of evil or righteousness,
the evil
you'll be
dick
going down in places you've seen before. You'll collect pages of the Necronomicon, uncover Nobi's lost tapes, and track down other legendary artifacts. When you've grabbed enough, you'll use a spell to send the Kandarian son of a bitch back to the hellhole it came from. Soon you'll experience the horror yourself, but for now I'll leave you with this thought. It was no accident that Ash always wore brown pants.
That person could not aim. That looks pretty fun though. Looks like it could be fun. Gonna get ice cream? Hell yeah, get you some ice cream! Evil Dead. Oh shit. Damn. Not fond of the PvP aspect of that, though. But the rest of it looks cool.
Now it's time
for
the grand finale to the show.
Alright, this has not been a very good show for me personally. Then. Today, this could be nice, though.
I am
though.
So deeply honored to be given the opportunity to share this next game.
Is it Elden Ring?
One of our industry's most acclaimed developers.
Is it Elden Ring?
Game of the Year winner at the Game Awards.
I want to it's Elden Ring! Well, I don't care. This sucked. I'm not gonna lie, I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. I really did not like this show. This was super boring for quite a lot of it.
So, without further ado, please.
Without further dudes.
Enjoy this truly spectacular world premiere. It is finally time.
Half-Life 3. I'm joking. Could you imagine, though? I know people have been excited for this game. I personally just do not care. I'm not really a Souls guy, so I don't have the hype for this game. I'm just like, I think for me, knowing that the big thing is something I don't care about, I already feel like just saying, right, okay, bye, and just leaving, because I do not give a shit. I really don't care.
The Tarnished will soon return. Guided by grace.
Welcome back, Artslink. What kind of ice cream did you get? I'm really curious.
The Golden Order is broken to its core.
He's got a bell for testicles. He's got a bell end. He said the thing.
By the flame of ambition, someone must extinguish thy flame.
Roll credits. This is Breath of the Wild now? Revali Scale is now ready! Dragon's Dogma. Unicorn ice cream cone? That's pretty cool. I've seen some of those. We have those as well over here in a store nearby. We've not tried them yet, though. I've been tempted to. They're pretty good. Cool. What do they taste like? I've been curious about them. Was that a giant hand? The fuck? Was that a man in a loincloth? Also, what the fuck?
For all of us.
That's cool artwork. Oh, people are gonna lose their shit at that. Holy fuck. I can hear Twitter. I can hear it.
It actually happened. Elden Ring is coming, as you saw, January 21st, 2022, to next gen.
Feels bad, man. I was not a fan of this show. Most of the show, I think I spent being bored or complaining.
In-game look at I hope you guys are happy. Oh my god, I'm free! Out of prison, alright?
Well, like I said, I am going to be checking out the Wholesome Games Devolver and Gearbox streams on June the 12th, so hopefully those will be good. Because this wasn't really that good for me, personally. It really was not that fun. Some chocolates and vanilla with another taste, and it's sort of like berries. Hmm, that sounds nice.
And this is really just the kickoff.